Today I'll be discussing about money, mula, pesa, farifari. I don't know about you, but I love me some money. And I'm not like a finance coach. Let me put that as a disclaimer. I'm not a finance coach. I'm also in the process of learning about money, how to make it, how to invest it, how to save it, how to use it, all those things. I'm in the process of learning all those things. And my main topic today is how to avoid wasting money. And every time I make a video, I tell you this, and I've said this sometimes, a million times before, I don't tell you on things that I've not done. I tell you things that I've done and they have worked. Not only have I done it, but I've done it and it has worked. I hope it works for you and I hope you learn something. The motive of this channel is that you come here and learn and overcome. That is my main purpose, and the reason why I started this channel is that you overcome. Now, without any further ado, I'm just going to go straight to the video. And if you're new here, karibu sana, and use that subscribe button to subscribe to this channel. And if you've not watched all those other videos that I've made around 30 something videos, go back and watch all of those videos. Mpaka tufike hapo penye tumefika, ndio tuende tukiendanga. Karibu sana to my channel and enjoy this video. There are some things we do, we normalize doing them, and we don't realize that we are wasting money in the process of doing those small things. They look like normal, maybe they look like you're not, it's simply because you're not taking a large amount of money and buying those things. You think that you're not wasting money, but if you sit down and write them down and actually do the calculation of the amount of money you've used on those small things, they'll end up being a lot of money. You'll end up noticing or realizing that you've wasted a huge amount of money. And now, the first thing I want you to know is that if you have kids, this is for women with kids, avoid buying too many clothes for them. Avoid buying too many clothes for them. I decluttered my kids' clothes, and I realized that some of the clothes that we bought, they've never even worn them, and they have outgrown the clothes. Okay, so you find that you bought that dress or that trouser or that particular cloth that they've never worn, so you end up giving it away. Giving it away is not a bad thing, but you had bought it for your child, and you they didn't even wear that dress or that pair of shoe, by the way. Why should you have a lot of pairs, a huge pair of shoes or many clothes, which at the end of the day they are not going to wear, or they're not going to wear them, because they grow very fast. Kids, you realize that when you work here to live after some few months, that child cannot wear that shoe, and you can't buy a big shoe to say miatava hivyo mpaka ile time yenye at outgrow. So I'll add that you buy what they need, like you buy what they need, because most of the times, especially now that they're in school, anaenda shule, anashinda na uniform, anakuja jioni, maybe the child showers and they put on their sleeping clothes. When did they wear those clothes that you had bought so many of them? You find that you have so many clothes, even you don't even have space to keep some of those things. And for what? For no reason. So avoid buying, just buying clothes for the sake of buying. If you're buying clothes for maybe going out or going to church, don't buy like 50 trousers. These are all those things that are, by the time in Amaliza, you're doing the 50th one. I shall outgrow your nguo. So you just buy what makes sense. Like, you can buy, I don't know about you, but I don't do that huge buying. I don't buy many clothes. I decluttered, and I came to realize that was a waste of money. It's not a lot of money, but no matter how little it is, you are going to save money from that. So avoid buying so many clothes for your children, because they are growing. Just akigrow, when you're 21 and akigrow, you can just get rid of that load and buy some other new clothes that are fitting them or that will fit them. My point number two, buying bad quality things. This one is something that I've experienced. And let me tell you, I am a lover of shoes. If you know me, you know that I love shoes. I have a shoe that I bought. I'm not going to mention the amount I bought that shoe for, because it was expensive. But let me tell you something. That shoe has lasted me for 10 plus years. I bought that shoe when my sister was in Form 2. I think she was in Form 2. Now she's married with two kids. You can imagine it, do your math. I bought that shoe for a huge amount of money, but I can tell you for sure that shoe has given, it has served me so well that I can't complain. That's saying I'm not wearing this shoe anymore. it has done me justice. So avoid buying bad quality. Bad quality. Because you're going to buy again and again and again and again. Me tu niko ile na moja tu. You may think I wasted money, but you're the, when you look, when you put it, when you put things in the on the table that this is how much I bought this, and you how many pairs of shoes maybe you've bought, or how many handbags you've bought, or whatever you've bought, and I bought one at a very expensive price, you might end up, we might end up finding out that you used a lot of money than I who bought one at an expensive price. Do you understand? So under any circumstance, avoid buying bad quality products or avoid buying bad quality things. If you can just invest in, other than you go in a kitu moja, lakini you know that thing is of good quality and it's going to serve you. Rather than having like 10 and they are useless, they are going to disappoint you. Actually, there's a could disappoint just anywhere. So the second thing you need to do is that you buy good quality products or good, really just buy good quality products, okay? Good. The other thing is not having a plan. Not having a plan. Having a plan, let me tell you, when it comes to a home, if you have a family, having a plan is making sure that you know what you're cooking and what you're buying. Let me give you an example. I used to shop for a certain amount of money, and I never had a plan. Like, I didn't know what we are doing, what we are cooking, where to, what we are cooking, what, when. So I made this timetable of what we are cooking on Monday, from Monday to Sunday. And I came to realize, when you make a plan, you know you're eating rice twice a week. Let me give an example of rice. You're eating rice twice a week. How many cups of rice do you consume per meal? If you're doing 2 cups, then it is very easy for you to do a very quick math. If you're doing 2 cups of rice a day and you do rice twice a week, that can give you that can approximate, it can give you a rough idea of how many kgs of rice you're going to use at the end of the month. Because mostly a cup of tea, a cup of rice is about a half a kg. So you're doing 2 cups a week, doing 2 cups a day. That is, those are 4 cups a week. How many kgs of rice are those? That is 1 kg of rice. That can tell you easily that you need 4 kgs of rice to take you to the end of the month. That is what I mean by planning. Make sure you plan everything that you need. When you plan your meals, it's easy for you to tell the amount of money you're going to use at the end of the month for your shopping. It's so easy because you know, I need this, I need this, I do this. At the end of the day, you know exactly what you need at the end of the month. And you're able to put that money aside so that any other money that comes, you can do something else, or you can save, or you can invest, or you can do all those other things. If you want to use, you go ahead and use it. But you know, when you have a plan, you know that this is what I need at the end of every month. So inezaenda juu kidogo, inezaenda chini kidogo, but inarangia tu hapo. I don't know why it should go up, because when you know exactly what you need, I don't see a reason why it should go up and down. It should be consistent. Maybe unless you have a visitor or something, but when you know this is the particular amount of money I use, you're able to plan and you're able to do your savings well. And like, if you don't know, this month you've used 5,000, the next month you use 20, the next month you use 15, it doesn't make sense. Have a plan. Have a plan in your house. This is what I used. It doesn't go below this. It doesn't go above this. And it's going to help you save you some money. The next thing I need you to understand is, make, if you have a house help, make sure that you give, you make rules. Yani, you make sure you tell that person how. If maybe you never used to have a house help, and now that now you have a house help, you need one, or you must have one. Make sure you tell her what you do, what is expected of that home. If you, like I said in my previous point, if you're doing shopping worth 10,000, I don't see why you should start doing shopping worth 20,000 simply because you wanted one person in your house, that is your house help or your house manager or whatever you call them. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. If at all you've added a new person, make sure you tell them, when they come, this is how we do things. This is the timetable we follow. This is what we do. Show them so that you can avoid them wasting or diverting from your plan. You need to put them in your plan and tell them, this is how I do things. This is how we run this home. And these are the rules that you should follow. So fill them in and let them know what you do, and let them know what is expected of them. so that you can avoid wastage. Because kuna watu unasikianga, I've heard people complaining. After I got a house, girl, now my shopping has doubled, my water has... It shouldn't double. Increasing it can increase a little bit, but doubling for one person, it doesn't add up. It doesn't make sense at all. And you can know when people are just... Like, I had a house girl who used to give out my shopping. And I never used to notice because you leave early in the morning, come back late. They are the ones in the kitchen, so you never notice. But if you have a plan, you know that these 10 kgs of rice are going to take us for 2 months or 1 month. If you start buying 20 kgs, you notice this. It's alarming, okay? So that is going to help you understand that when you set rules and you tell them, we use this at the end of every month. So by the time they decide to do anything fishy, they know that you know what is expected or what should be done in that home. The next thing I need you to buy, to understand, that can help you save money is avoid buying things in small quantities. Unless maybe you've lost your job or something, that you don't have money and you need to buy. You know, there are times that you survive from hand to mouth. That one is that particular mall. It's not a permanent situation. It's going to pass. But if you're in that situation, that is okay. But if you can buy things in large quantities, and I'll tell you this, when you buy a packet of Pampers, let me give you an example with Pampers. If you buy a packet of Pampers, the bigger one, it goes for around a 550 and 60 there. And that is about 14 shillings per Pamper. That is per piece. It's around 14 to 15 shillings per piece. But if you decide to buy every day at the estate shop, it goes for 20 shillings. You do your math. You're saving 7 shillings for a pack of how many pieces? I think they're around 60 pieces or so. So you can do your math and see who is saving a lot. So if you can avoid buying things in small quantities, that is going to help you save a lot of money. Everything that you buy, ukiangalia hata kwa mchele, like the way they put that price list, they put like 1 kg is 150, half a kg is 80 bob, and a quarter kg is certain price. It when you multiply the half, it end a June knock some coins na ile ya 1 kg. So if you would buy things in big quantities, just it's going to save you a lot of money. But if you can't, still utafika tu hapo. Just take baby steps. It's not, whatever you're going through is not permanent. My next step, letting your children now. Let me tell you something. If you can talk to your if you have kids and they go to school, if it's not compulsory for them to eat from school, you can they can just carry food from home. They can carry food from home. And let me tell you something. I got a list when I was transferring my kids. When we transferred our kids from the school they used to be to now the school they are right now, we got that list to napewa ini, the requirements. And one of those things were the meals. They were optional. You can pack them or they can eat from school. And we checked the price of them eating from school. It was so expensive. Almost the two of them, because the two of them are in school, the amount they were required to pay for them to have meals in school was almost half the amount of the shopping we do monthly. You can imagine. So we made a decision, they are going to be carrying food from home. And I made a sacrifice, whether I'm working or I'm not working, or whether I'm at home or I'm going to work, I'm going to make sure that I'm the one who packs their lunch. I invested in good quality dishes that keep the food hot, not warm, hot, like they tell me the food was hot. And a good teapot, kaleka chupakachai, that one, you invest in good quality. And imagine, it's not that it's a 15 minutes job, and your kitu sha pack, you've packed everything and they are ready to go. So if you can, if it's optional, if the school allows for them to carry food from home, I'd urge that you take that chance and just let them carry food from home. It's going to be cheaper, it's healthy, because you made that food, you know what is in that dish. So if you can, just let your kids carry food from home. But if it's not, they have to eat from school, well and good, it's still fine. And the last thing I want to share is buying things that you don't need. Let me tell you something. I told a friend of mine, I don't buy things especially ladies, they're buying the utensils. I don't buy more utensils than my house can hold. Let me tell you what I mean. My house can hold 10 people. For instance, 10, max of 15. Mkikama mmekuja, it's impossible. But if you're big, you're not, you can only hold 10, the 10 of you. So, max 15 people in the house. Where are you having 40 plates in your house? Where are you having 90 cups in your house? What are they? What? And nowadays, people have evolved. People are doing outside catering. They come with everything. Where are you having so many utensils? At a zina place ya kweka zingino umeka chini ya kitanda. For what reason? Some even you, the last time you used those things, only God knows when. And you're buying all those, every time you see them, you buy. Why don't you buy things or the utensils that your house can hold? You have seats that can accommodate 15 to 10 people and you're buying a million plates in your house. What are you doing to yourself? If you host guests oftenly, you can do that. But when was, can you sit down and ask yourself these questions? When was the last time you had guests in your house? What had they come to do? You know, it's not like a normal thing for them to keep coming. Maybe it was an occasion. Maybe you had a housewarming. Maybe you had a birthday party. Maybe you had a baby shower, all those things. And it is only once. How many times do you have birthday parties? Once per year. So I don't see why you should fill your house with so many utensils, so many dishes. Because in your kitchen space, you're wondering what you're going to do with them. Just don't buy things that are not necessary. You'll rather buy small, beautiful, expensive thing, utensils, and then you keep changing every now and then. You can save for it, change every now and then. Maybe you can change them annually if you want to. If you don't want to, good for you. But to see vyombo hapa tu kazi yako ni kutoa kupanguza vumbi, kurudisha, kutoa kupanguza vumbi, it doesn't make sense. Buy what you need, buy what is necessary. Just don't go buying things because you saw them on online or maybe whatever you saw them. So I hope those are going to help you. Those tips are going to help you save a coin or two. If you can save out of all those things, ufanye tu wendu kikata kota kata kata. Usave tu hata kama ni 2K. Imagine 2K is a lot of money. You can do it. You can save it in your retirement. Okay, so I hope it has been of help. I hope you're going to learn something. Tag along a person who you know needs to watch this video, and I know it's gonna be a blessing. And until next week, bye bye.